Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we are going to cover how to apply vertical analysis. Vertical analysis, also called common size analysis, evaluates financial statement items relative to a current period base amount. It is called vertical analysis because we compare numbers up and down, rather than side to side like we do with horizontal analysis. So, to perform a vertical analysis, we usually compute something called common size percentages. To do this, assume a company reports current assets of $28,000 and total assets of $112,000. And we want to know the relative size of current assets to total assets. To compute this, we take the analysis amount, which is current assets of $28,000, and divide it by the base amount, which is total assets of $112,000. And this gets us the common size percentage of 0.25 or 25%, meaning current assets is 25% of total assets. We can do this common size computation for all balance sheet items using total assets or total liabilities plus equity as the base amount for the current year and the prior year. Looking at the common size percentages, we see that current assets are 25% or less of this company's total assets for both years. We also see that the company is mainly financed with liabilities. For example, for the current year, total liabilities account for 76.8% of its financing, while stockholders' equity accounts for just 23.2%. We also see a slight increase in the percentages financed from equity in the current year, from 20% to 23.2%. Much of this change in equity is due to an increase in retained earnings, from 16.2% to 18.8%. This increase in retained earnings is due to the company's reinvestment of net income into the business. Another notable change is the decrease in long-term liabilities, from 61.4% to 58%. We can also apply vertical or common size analysis to the income statement. For example, assume a company reports net sales of $110,000 and cost of goods sold of $66,000. To compute common size percentage for cost of goods sold, we take the analysis amount, which is the cost of goods sold of $66,000, and divide it by the base amount, which is net sales of $110,000. This gets us a common size percentage of 0.60 or 60%, meaning cost of goods sold is 60% of net sales. We can do this common size computation for all income statement items using net sales as the base amount for the current year and the prior year. Using these common size percentages, we see that net income increased from 10% to 11.4% of net sales. This means that total expenses make up a smaller percentage of net sales for the current year compared with the prior year. This is a positive change and is mainly due to the percentage decreases in costs of goods sold from 62% to 60%. We also see that interest expense decreased from 3% to 2.7% of net sales. This is because net sales increased while the dollar amount of interest expense did not change. However, common size percentages for selling expenses and for general and administrative expenses both increased. This is not a good change, and the company will need to watch those costs to keep them under control.